Hi, Dr. Manya. How are you doing?
Hi, I'm good. Thank you so much for having me at your hotspots.
So I would like you to introduce yourself, what services you are providing at Maya Aesthetic Clinic, and how are things going with you right now?
Okay, well, thank you for your kind introduction. All of you know that already I'm from an ENT background and I have done my fellowship in facial plastic and reconstructive surgery. So, all kind of surgical as well as non-surgical facial rejuvenation procedures we offer at our clinic, starting from MediFacials, PRP to microneedling with radiofrequency, mesotherapy to Botox fillers, facelift, nanofat grafting. So these are the procedures which involve at either like a surgical or a non-surgical rejuvenation, which leads you to anti-aging. So these are the procedures which we do.
Okay, that's lovely to hear, Dr. Mania, because we in our previous YouTube videos have never come across this field of healthcare. So it's really quite enlightening for us also to know about this and our fellow followers as well from the YouTube. So we'll come back to few questions. We'll come to some questions which we have from our end. So when you talk about facial aesthetic surgery, can you give a little bit more input on what exactly is this about? And which age group usually you cater in this, who should come to you, and how is the progress on this particular service which you provide at Maya Aesthetic?
Okay, so there are like a lot of questions, too many questions at once. But yeah, facial aesthetic surgery basically it comprises of the surgeries which makes you feel young. So basically, these are the procedures, they don't require any kind of age. It depends on how you are aging according to your skin and your environment. A person of 25 to 30 years can have a little laxity or hair loss, which everybody age differently according to their physiological age as well as their skin age. So we provide blepharoplasty, which is called as eyelid surgery. That is in common man terms, if you have seen, a lot of people they suffer from lateral torsions or hooding of eyelids, especially when
That's
they
right.
grow around mid-40s and mid-30s or in later age also. So we do blepharoplasty for them. Then there are many patients who have sagging jowls, deeper nasolabial folds, and also they have a lot of neck laxity, like a turkey neck we say. So we do neck lift as well as lower jaw rejuvenation and jaw contouring surgeries as well. Now it depends on patient to patient whether they want this to be corrected surgically or non-surgically. So we
Okay.
have both the kind of options depending on the age. It's not straight away that when the patient is coming to you have to do a Botox fillers or you have to directly advise him on facelift surgery. Every patient has to be individualized, and according to their like three parts of the face, we generally divide the face into three parts, upper, middle and lower third, and depending on what part requires which kind of rejuvenation, we plan it and tailor-made it according to individual patient, and that's how we go for.
Okay, sounds very exciting, ma'am. So, in your practice, which gender do you come across commonly? Is it more of female or male gender as well?
Actually, both come these days. Even males are also coming, but males they come mostly more for a hair loss treatment and under eye dark circles and laser this your beard shaping and all that.
Okay.
And females they come for more for MediFacial, skin brightening and anti-aging treatments. It's like that.
Okay. So when we talk about women who come across for these facial procedures or aesthetic surgeries, how it is the affordability or the cost factor to the cosmetic factor a woman should think about when she wants to enter a facial aesthetic clinic like yours?
Sure. Basically, what happens, generally people they turn toward an anti-aging clinic when they're already turning old and they have elicited the signs of aging. Ideal age is when somebody is in their 20s, they should start the anti-aging treatments as well as proper skin care. So that's very crucial that at what age they are entering. And depending on that, we can give them surgical and non-surgical options. Now
Okay.
the treatment can be the MediFacials, they can start from either even like 2,000 rupees to even 15,000 rupees.
Okay.
See, we have got Mercedes, we have got Maruti 800. It's like that. Just understand that way. So
Right,
it's
right.
basically patient's budget, and it's basically how patient wants their procedure to be. They want the downtime or not. many a times the patient, they request me that, madam, I will get a facial done, but I should not have downtime. Nobody should know that I have undergone any kind of aesthetic procedure done. So that these are the things that we have to keep in mind. Apart from that, we always give options to the patients. Okay, you have a microneedling therapy, you have MNRF, you have exosomes, you have thread lifts, you also have hydrating boosters as well. So we offer them all, we tell them what are the effects, side effects, and what are the duration of action the procedure will last for and when its effect will be completely gone. And according to that, they choose it and, you know, they plan it accordingly for a 6 months treatment, for a year treatment or so.
So, Dr. Manya, when I went through your achievements and accolades, I happen to know that you have pursued qualifications for the same from Singapore and Korea. As much of medical knowledge I have, Korea is the hub of facial aesthetic activity. So, after pursuing your qualification from these two countries, what is the difference you got, what you had learned in a country like India, and how that practically helped you in your private practice as well?
Yeah, that's a very nice question to go for. The South Korea, as we all know, that it's a cosmetic hub all across the world. For example, if you talk about PRP in South Korea, they will say it is outdated. They have stopped using it from like last 7 to 10 years. It's like that. So they are far ahead from us in terms of cosmetology and things. When my motto for repetitive trainings was that I wanted to bring the best, medical regimen, the best protocols for my patients. Right. Because I will be, working on the face, and when patients come to you in a facial aesthetic clinic, they have a very high expectations, and I should be able to offer them all the surgical as well as non-surgical options. Being a doctor, it should not be like that. My practice should limit myself at Botox and fillers and some Medifacial. It should not be like that. Basically, I have to rationalize my treatment. If my patient needs surgery, I have to offer him surgery and do a surgery for him. If a patient needs a non-surgical, I have to stick to a non-surgical regimen. And that's why it made me, travel over there. And there the people are very much, conscious about their skin care. And they have all the kind of latest equipments, latest protocols, which are not used over here in India. So that's why it helped me a lot to give a good deliverable results and predictable results for my patients. And also it has refined me that I can run my practice well as give a lasting result, which is not easily seen in the faces, if you can compare.
That's really nice to know. Dr. Manya, Raipur has really got a great doctor to take care of in terms of aesthetics. Another question which people have in their mind, that when they go across such kind of treatments or such kind of procedures, what are the long-term effects or side effects, if I call, for a human being when that person goes across such procedures? Can you enlighten more on that as well?
Yeah, sure. The long term, if you want to say it as a side effect, it will be that if you continue to take procedures, you will be into an anti-aging mode. That's the only long term side effects. Basically, see, in the world, everything is a poison. If you even take a salt, if you take it in excess, it's a poison. So basically, if you do all the things in the right way, you get all your procedures right in a appropriate manner with a qualified professional, there are not any kind of side effects. These are basically cosmetic procedures which are meant to make you more beautiful. Yeah, but when it comes to surgery, there are relative risks with the surgery. But as such, even with this good trained professional, you will not be able to have any kind of long-term or kind of side effects. But yeah, if surgical procedure carries a risk, as a surgery will do. But non-surgical procedures, as such, they don't have side effects. Only thing is that you will look your age if you stop doing that. That's it.
Achha.
Otherwise, there are no side effects.
There is no systemic side effects to the body.
No, not at all. Not at all. Even the IV boosters we give glutathione for skin brightening and all that. You will definitely see improvement in your sleep, your anxiety, your irritableness. It helps you a lot, not only in skin brightening. I don't say people, okay, you will become like 5 tones lighter or 3 tones lighter. We just promise them that if your skin will become even tone, you will have a little glow and your skin will match with your chest or pinna skin. That way we promise. But apart from that, when we give them along with other antioxidants, it leads you to anti-aging mode. It decreases the the harmful side effects of the free radicals which your body generate. And it turns into an anti-aging mode. It turns your body into an anti-aging mode. So that's the advantage of having these treatments. And even if you will go for even skin resurfacing treatment we do, or PRP also, growth factors, exosomes, they also, just snatch away the aging skin. They snatch away the dead skin and rejuvenate your skin to an extent that they again stop showing the signs of aging, the fine lines, the pigmentation, the pore damage. So these all get reversed or get delays.
That's really nice to know about this new field. Now that you have been practicing in Raipur for quite a long time, as a doctor, what I figure out when it comes to procedures like this, bigger towns and especially cosmopolitan cities really have demand for such kind of services or procedures which we look out for. How about a place like Raipur? Does that demand also comes in a city like Raipur for you?
With this, Raipur is a tier two city basically, and since it has been become a capital, a lot of development has happened. And even now the people are becoming aware of the treatments. They come with the name of the Alma, that we want LHR from Alma. They are inquiring about the salmon DNA, the exosomes. So gradually the people are opening up too, since the awareness is increasing. And the affluent business class or the celebrity class or the people who are into continuous public relations, like air hostesses, cabin crew, they all want to save their time and be camera ready all the time. So they all want to get done. So mostly my clients are the college going students or the patient who are have to save their time, because these days time is money, and these procedures make you keep your camera ready, keep your filter without filters, and they make you look good all the time without makeup. It's like that.
That's really enlightening and really knowing a lot about this subject. I'm sure with one talk show this will not get over. I'm sure you have a lot of things which we need to understand on the other procedures you do as well. So we will have a quick conclusion to this meet. A few questions I want to know as a fellow medical doctor to you. I want to give your inputs or your thoughts on entering into this particular stream or field for an upcoming and budding doctor, like person who is pursuing MBBS in today's date. What will be his roadmap or his goal if he wants to become a healthcare practitioner for the stream which you have selected? Can you please guide on that? That will be my first question. And second question is that what are the opportunities for this particular practice which you are doing in a country like India to an overseas country? So what will be your advice for that budding doctor?
See, I come from an ENT background, and I started developing interest in aesthetics during my post-graduation day. We used to perform rhinoplasty, we used to learn rhinoplasty at that time. So what happens, because of the climate in the India and the extremes of temperatures, the patient used to get a lot of hypertrophic scar or pigmentation on the scars whenever there's any kind of surgery used to happen in this face. So that was, and patients in India, they don't follow appropriate skin care, they don't apply sunscreen. So whenever we used to put up an incision, it used to he it although the whole surgery used to went well, but scarring at the end after 3 months of the procedure used to happen. So that's why I came into aesthetics, that if we have to do a rhinoplasty or you have to do a facelift surgery, or even see if we go for even a thyroid surgery, we have a big scar on the throat. So all the females this day, they don't want to have a big scar. Everybody asks about, okay, how much stitches I have got. If you every layman asks that, right? So that pushed me, oh, one should know the skin care, and we should do the surgeries after making the skin healthy or skin conditions right, so that our scar heals well. The collagen in the skin itself becomes tremendous, that it helps in healing, and that's how I came into aesthetics. So if I do a rhinoplasty now, there is no scar. The patient can hardly see any kind of scar in their face. Or if I do a parotid or any kind of neck surgery or blepharoplasty also, you will be able to hardly see any kind of scar or pigmentation on the operated area. And that's the reason I came into aesthetics. And gradually then I evolved. Okay. Apart from that, in terms of finances also, for me, time is money. So when I do ear surgeries, I do everything in ENT. But in aesthetic, the procedures are mostly injectables, and even if surgical, they are all daycare procedures mostly, apart from facelift. So it's also saves a lot of energy, and in terms of finances also, they are very satisfying. So, and it also create a immediate transformation to the patient. Patient becomes immediately happy when you you know transform their lives. It immediately boosts their confidence. So that makes me happy. So because looks these days is very crucial in everybody's life. So
absolutely.
And
absolutely.
If when you you know enhance somebody's beauty, it boosts their relationships and confidence like that.
So thank you, Dr. Manya, for giving this valid insight about the practice which you are having. I'm sure we will have another session, especially about what is Botox treatment and the latest treadlifts which you were talking of with me. We will have a separate session on that. And for all my viewers, thank you so much for getting connected. Do like, share and subscribe this video. And you will also see Dr. Manya's clinic details, the services which she is offering and the phone numbers, which you can easily reach out and get all your doubts and queries clear for this lady. Thank you so much, Dr. Manya, for your valid time. Take care and goodbye. Okay.
Sure. Thank you.